At this point, you have this, you have the fourth one here, and you make a display with the three. Set this in front or in back, it doesn't matter. When you pick this up, you load the two and you hold it this way. This one is one, two, and the third one goes into the pocket. You emphasize this hand. How many does that leave here? A little bit of misdirection. Say two. Then you go for the one, still maintaining the fourth one. Say no, I have three. Again, I'll do it one more time. One, two. Third one goes into the pocket this time. Say, if I placed one into my hand, how many does that leave here? So I say two. I say no, leaves three. Do it one more time. There's one, there's two, and the third one goes into the pocket. How many then does that leave in my hand? How many?
Two.
None. You do this, you go.
That is
the case. That's it. That's the routine I do. I mean, I do many, but that's the one I always come back to. It's simple, direct, and people can follow it. And they know where you're at, you know where they're at.
Right. That's really nice.
That's good.
Okay?
Great. Love it.
Love it. Well, is there anything else you can think of?
Okay.
Right. It's okay now.
Frank Garcia on wild card. Two versions.
About the persistent one, too?
Oh, it's running. It's all right.
Okay.
Pull the mic up. Tighten in the back.
Maybe it's better if I stand up for this.
All right,
I'll
fine.
Do the thing here. Yeah, I feel more comfortable. I have here nine cards, eight of which are identical, one of which is an indifferent card, and I refer to that as the wild card. What do you see here, Bob?
Ace of spades.
Ace of spades. Now, the ace of spades, I'll place one face down, one face up. What do you see here?
Ace of spades.
One goes face. One goes face down, one face up. What do you see here?
Ace of spades.
Okay. One face down, one face up. And here?
Ace of spades.
One face down, and one face up. This is the card that I was talking to you about, the wild card. If I were to take the joker and place it on to the ace of spades and do this, what happens? It changes into a joker. Do this again. I have to work faster because the print is drying, so if you believe, anything is possible. That's a second one. Third one, by way of variation, I'll do this way. There are two jokers here. And last but not least, have to work much faster now. We have another one. Both faces and backs. People often ask me, they say, how do I do this? I say, extremely well, but I call your attention to the fact that the cards have backs here, and here, and here. This one I'll turn over. This one has a face and a back. That has a face and a back. I'll do this again for you. Try and contain yourself, Bob. There's a back here. Face. Face. Back. Face. Back. One more time. There's a back here. Turn the card over. There's a face here, a back. Face and a back. And last but not least, back here, turn it over, there's a face in the back, face in the back.
That's great.
That really is, that is a great one.
But you know what's nice about this, because assumedly they see the faces in the backs.
Yes, yes. Assume you do.
Well,
right.
Now, how do you lay it out?
All right, here. This is the layout. You know the general thing. You have five straight jokers.
Yeah.
And then you have the four aces with jokers on the back,
right.
The double faces. So at the onset of the trick, what you do, you place and you intersperse the aces every other card.
Mm-hmm.
So you have a gaffer, straight joker, gaffer, straight, gaffer, straight, gaffer, and two regular.
Mm-hmm.
That's your starting position.
And it's the glide.
Mm-hmm. Now, do you want me to show you on that?
Sure,
or?
Go ahead and show it on
all right.
The
table. So what I'm going to do, you call attention to the fact, you first say that you have nine cards, eight of which are identical, one of which is an oddball card, whatever the combination is that you use. You hold this in glide position. Now, in turning this over, what happens, let's assume that I turn my hand over by applying pressure with a pinky. You pull back. And that's covered by doing this.
Right.
You see? Mm-hmm. In other words, don't turn over and then do the glide.
Right.
So you get that. It's done in the turnover so that you have that. Now, don't grapple with the card. The best way to do this is to pull this out because that's the way you would pull out a card.
Mm-hmm.
And you set it down. Now, you have this condition.
Yes.
So to offset that, you place the index finger here, and as you turn around,
you push it,
in.
Mm-hmm.
And pull, peel this back. Assumedly, they've seen two aces.
Mm-hmm.
They're suspected. What is this? Ace of spades, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
Again, you repeat. These cards are sticky.
Mm-hmm.
And you do so, straighten out the card, and you repeat this four times. Like so. They refer to that as a catalyst card. These are the gaffers, and the face down cards are already jokers, so the rest is acting ability on your part. Give that little snap. Now, in turning this over, it's a modified Mexican switch, but it's not really, and there's a discrepancy. You anchor the ace, the double face with the middle finger, scoop up, turn it over very much like you would a page in a book, and then pull out towards you.
Okay? Disclosing a gaffer, which
right.
You've already
right.
Disclosed.
But there's a discrepancy there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, when you play it back, you'll see what I'm talking about.
Right.
Now you just repeat this again, and you can make the card vanish whichever way you fancy. You do that as you switch again.
Mm-hmm.
Do so, show the faces and the backs as you switch again. And the last time, the switch again.
Mm-hmm.
Now the beautiful part is, the face-up cards of the gaffers, these are the straight ones.
Mm-hmm.
You scoop this up. You say, look, there's a back here, and there's a back on this side. You hold this in dealing position. If you apply pressure with your thumb, what happens, and you push, you're pushing off two cards.
Mm-hmm.
Now you pick up, holding them square, you turn them over. When I throw this card down, I'm throwing down
the gaffer.
The gaffer. You refer to the second one. It has a face and it has a back. Of course, this one has a face and a back.
Mm-hmm.
You do it again. See, there are backs here, backs here. Push off, turn over. I get rid of the evidence. Face, back, face, back. I just repeat. Call attention to the backs, apply pressure, getting rid of the evidence, face, back, and last but not least, you turn it over, calling attention to the two backs, push off, get rid of the evidence here, face, back, and that's all there is to it. Huh? I'll show you, you want to shut it off for a moment?
Yeah.
So you don't waste
any. Yeah, you can just push it there.
Nine cards, eight of which are identical, one of which is an oddball card. This is a little more difficult to do, but it's nice. You then count the cards. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now four of these aces I'll place face down like so. Four of the aces I'll place face up like so. Now this is the catalyst card. If I scoop this up and place them to the aces, believe it or not, I now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 jokers. Interestingly enough, not only did I print the faces, but you'll notice that I also printed the backs. You seem a bit confused, so I'll do this batch a little slower. There are the four aces. I'll turn them over and lay them out here. Remember, these are the ones that I've just printed. So that if I take one of the aces, do so, there's a joker. There's another one. I led you down the garden path. And there's another one. That's it.
Now go ahead.
All right? No. Same set of cards. You have your, let me see. Your five straight jokers. And you take the aces and place them on top. Now you'll do what is called the Brother Hammond count.
Okay, we should turn the radio off.
Can I?
Yeah, okay.
Now, the Hammond count is nothing more than a false count that brings back the original packet of cards to its original condition. So I'll do it in slow motion. Look. You peel off ace number one, you count one, second ace two, three, four. Now, at this point, this is the crucial part. This finger, my third finger, is loose so that I jog this here and I grip this batch, thus switching. Five, six, seven, eight, nine.
You do that once more.
Okay. Shall I do it explaining it or?
Yeah, I'm gonna get close on it.
Okay, so here, you hold it with the thumb and the middle finger. You slide off. One, counting it as one, two, three. Oh, wait a minute. Cards attacking with the lights. One, two, three, four. Jog, pick up on the ace packet, leaving the other one. Counting this as five, six, seven, eight, nine. Now, you turn this over, you say, I'm going to lay four of the aces face down. They've seen the backs, but they don't realize that these are the gaffers. So you turn this over and you say, and four of them I'll lay face up. Can I take care of it?
Okay.
Now at this point, since these are already jokers, you can change them individually or you can just do as I do, like so. Scoop up, make a pass over it. Say, believe it or not, we have one, two, three, four, five jokers. All well and good. Now you pick them up and say, interestingly enough, not only did I print the faces, but also the backs. Now for the move, which is beautiful. You pick up the gaff cards. Of course, you don't show them this way, just for the camera. As I show this, I push and apply pressure with my left thumb, pushing off a block of four. Now, in squaring this up, you square the whole lot up and you turn over eight cards. You lay out, assumedly, what you've just shown. These are the gaffers now. You just drop them out on the table. This last one is straight. So you say, these are the ones that I just printed. So one at a time, you do this. There's a joker. There's another one. There's another one. And there's one. Isn't that pretty?
Yeah.
All right.
This is the stretching queen?
Yeah, this is the stretching queen. This is interesting because I utilized two red tens and a black queen, calamity chain. Now I discovered that if I did this, that queen always remains in the middle. And I also discovered that by reversing the procedure, that queen always stays in the middle. It's not too confounding, but it was when I first discovered it. I also noticed that by laying the cards out like so, that the queen still remained in the center. Not too much of a mystery, but what I intend to do is to take the queen, place it face down, in between the two. Ah, nuts.
Let me. I can't reverse it.
Sorry about that.
It's all right.
Must be the weather. Okay, see, this is even coming apart.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let me take it from the top.
Yeah.
Little mystery with three cards. A queen and two red tens. Count them this way, the queen remains in the center. Count them this way, the queen still remains in the center. We'll take the queen and place it face down. Now, if I turn that packet over, how should the queen be?
Face up.
Face up. Very good. Sandwiched in between the two tens. This is where the magic comes in. If I do this, well, it gives me the ability to stretch the queen. Of course, that's the easy part. The hard part is to get it back to its original size. Now, the kicker here is, remember, I only use three cards. There's the Queen of Spades. There's the Ten. And I can't show you this card because if I did, you would know how the whole trick is done.
Terrific.
Huh? Mm-hmm. All right, the gaff here is on the back side of the ten, you have half a queen. At the beginning of the trick, you place the real queen in the center and the fake with the queen facing you on top of the queen. So you start by reversing the count, showing the queen in the center, so the gaffer is here. Start by reversing the count. Again, the queen is still in the middle and the gaffer is here. Now you say you're going to play an interesting number. You're going to place the queen face down in between the two face-up tens. Slowly turn over the parcel of cards. Say, how should the queen be? And if someone says face down, you say, no, look. It's face down now. And if I turn the parcel of cards over, how should it be? They say face up. Now you stretch this. This is beautiful. Say, remember that sandwich in between the two tens. Now at which point you align the top card with the queen, push it forward about half an inch. Rub the circle and start stretching the queen. Like so. You say, this is easy. The hard part is to bring it back. All you do is squeeze it back. Turn the cards over and remove the queen. The gaffer is here. Now this move is very, very deceptive. You turn them over face down. You remove the queen, you see the back, and purposely turn it over. Now, because of the gaffer, I can only remove the card up to that point. So that's precisely what you do. You remove this one, and now you snap the card face up. Is it there?
Yeah.
Okay. Little trick done with a packet of cards. I'm going to have you, Bob, siriffle the cards in this fashion. You tell me when to stop.
Stop.
Right here. By virtue of the fact that you stopped me at the three, which has nothing to do with the trick, I'm going to remove the first face-down card I come to, which I'm going to place here. I don't want you to look at it just yet. Repeat performance. Tell me when to stop, Bob.
Stop.
Right here?
Yes.
Okay. By virtue of the fact that you stopped me at the jack, has nothing to do with the trick, I'm going to remove three cards, which I'm going to place directly behind the first card. I think you'll agree with me, random selection too, huh? Now, wouldn't it prove interesting if these three cards match that one? Mm-hmm. Yes or no?
Yes, it would.
Yeah, let's check them off. There's a king. It's not bad. There's another king. That's not bad. And this is the third king. We're very close to a miracle. If I've shown you the king of hearts, king of clubs, king of diamonds, then that card should be the king of spades. Yeah, I'll deal with the kings out first. Turn that over. That's an ace. It looks like a mistake. Actually, it was premeditated. If I take that ace and rub the back, I change it into a king. So that now, this king should match those kings. But this is where the magic comes in. I do this. Look what happens. There's an ace, second ace, third ace. And the true test is to change that.
Yeah, that's nice.
Isn't
that pretty?
It's like a comedy of errors.
Yeah. That's great. Well, now you got to explain that one.
Right.
I didn't show you this, did I?
No.
Okay. I referred to this, having been in England a number of times, the one in six, referring to the old currency. So you place the ace of spades here. That's one. That represents one. An indifferent card. I use a joke, you could use any card. And the king of spades, uppermost. The other kings, doesn't matter. Now the king of spades goes into sixth position. For example, that's your one. And one, two, three, four, five, six is the king of spades. One and six. Right? You pick this up the way you laid it out, that goes on top of the deck. Now, of course, you can show the deck up to a certain point. Don't do this and expose that. So you show it, say, casually, say, show you the life a little trick with an ordinary deck of playing cards, retaining the top stock. You approach the first spectator and you riffle in an upward direction, never in a downward, because this is what could happen. See?
Yes, yes.
So you go this way. Mm-hmm. And if you get too far up to the top, you start all over again. Right. Tell them when to stop. So they say stop. Okay. You turn it over. What has happened is that you reversed the initial stack. Mm-hmm. You remove a number of cards, like so, casting them aside. And this is already the ace of spades. Of course, the spectators don't know that. Mm-hmm. This is here. And this is your setup now again. Mm-hmm. So you just repeat. They say stop, you turn this over. Again, you revolve the stack. Now, by coincidence, I stopped at a three. So here it makes sense. You see, take the advantage of the opportunity by virtue of the fact that you stopped me at a three, I'm going to remove three cards. See?
Or three packets.
No, three cards.
Oh, I see.
See?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Right.
And this goes back on top. Mm-hmm. Now, because...
What if you don't reach a three?
It doesn't matter. You say, well, this has nothing to do with the trick, but in case...
I see.
Or if you turn over a four, you say, I'm going to remove three cards because I'm going to employ four cards.
Right.
All right? I'm just throwing that in anyway. Now you have this. Because you have five cards face up, that creates a natural break.
Yes.
Well, we can see it.
Mm-hmm.
So that it's very easy for me to pick up and maintain a break of the block of cards. As you check this out, there's a king. This goes on top of the block. This one goes on top of the block. And this one, you show and you reiterate. I stopped at the king of diamonds, king of clubs, king of hearts. You square them up and you turn the whole block over, automatically switching them for the aces, unbeknownst to the audience. Now at this point, you have this. So all you're doing, squaring up, is get a break of the two cards. Mm-hmm. Turn this over, prove it to be an ace. Now, I originally picked this up and placed it on top. I'll show you another method, which I like equally as well, by doing this. Now, there are two cards here, but they see one. You push down, pull back, and that affects the change. Show this not to be the ace. Now you have this. Mm-hmm. So you just pick up on the two, turn them over, refer to the king, or the ace as the king, and say, this king should then match these kings. Do this, say your magic words, and change them all into the aces.
Right. This trick?
I call it the six-way cut, triumph, out, done, whatever you...
Mm-hmm.
All right. Bob, I'm going to ask you, if you will, remove a card from the deck. Look at it, remember it, don't show it to me because I know the trick.
Show it to the camera.
Oh, okay.
All right, place the card back. What I'm going to do is give the deck a few cuts, apparently not thinking what I'm doing, mix them up like so, and give the deck a cut like so. I think you'll agree with me, the card is hopelessly lost in the deck. What I will do now is shuffle the cards face to face. But during the shuffle, please remember your card. Okay, so that what I do is what you see. Fair enough? Did you ever see this?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
You saw me do it.
Yeah, now I'm gonna push these in and strip them out like this. I think you'd agree with me that some of those cards would have to be face up, some face down, not an illusion.
Mm-hmm.
How long would it take you to unscramble this mess?
Well, going through 52 cards, as long as it takes you to redo 52 cards.
Well, that's fast, but you see, as a magician, I have to work a little faster. Now look, you realize that some of them are back to back. Faster than you can mention your name. You see it? It's done. All those cards are one way, with the exception of one. Lies here, face down. For the first time, name it.
Queen of Diamonds.
Queen of Diamonds. Great.
Yeah, he does it a lot smoother than you showed me, but you were good. You were good.
But that's it. The card was selected from the very beginning, inserted into the deck, replaced, and as I did this, I held a break. Now all I have to do in order to control the selected card to the top is take off little bits, little parcels of cards. Here, that's an exposed view. I think you can get it, Anna.
Yeah.
Like so, until I hit the break, this would be the selected card. Okay? You want the false card?
Yeah, no, what was the other thing you did? Taking them off two at a time, or forward
okay.
and backwards?
Well, here.
No, don't show that then. I'd like to see it. I don't know that slide.
All right, look. If I explain it to you, we'll have it on camera. And,
right, good.
Okay. Let me turn the card face up. What happens is, as I pull up, I apply pressure with my fingers and my right thumb,
right. Thus
peeling off the selected card.
Mm-hmm.
I do the same with the left, and that left thumb goes into the front,
gotcha.
So that, you see, that never
oh,
leaves.
Oh, that's a beauty.
That never leaves the back. From the front, it looks like you're mixing the cards.
Right.
Thanks.
Right.
Okay.
All right, now flip it over. We know it's on the top.
Okay.
Now do the false cut.
Now here, the false cut, here. Well, so you can follow it.
Yes.
Leave it face up. You approach the deck and you take a third of the deck from the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Place it here, leaving the packet extending. Now, you take the packet in the right hand along with the bottom, and that goes forward. The right hand comes back. And not one card has been disrupted. And that's called the Affis Gaffis cut. Now with the card on top, you split the packet to the right,
mm-hmm.
turning the one in the left hand over, showing the one in the right hand, explaining that you'll shuffle the cards face to face. Knee formation allows some cards from the left to fall first, and everything but the selected card, which comes to rest on top, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now the exposed view of the move.
Then you do the forward and backwards.
Yeah, I'm sorry, yeah. And you do this. What I do is what you see,
mm-hmm.
right? Now you come back. Apparently I'm gonna push the packet in. Actually what I'm doing just the reverse. I'm moving this card to the left. So here's an exposed view. Of course, my hand would be covering everything this way, but look, if I bear down and I push in this way.
Yeah, you haven't changed anything but the top card.
Okay. So now, by engulfing the deck this way, I'm hiding the protruding cards. Aerate the cards by riffling them, strip this out, and place this on top. So the end result is that you have half the deck face down, half the deck face up, and the selected card on top. At which point you draw it back and cut into any of the face-up cards, any one. Now you cut a third, leaving a third here, coming forward, and a third back. It gives you that formation, which is very confusing to the eye. Now you backtrack the same way, but instead of placing this on top, directly on top, jog it so they see the comparison, some face up, some face down.
Mm-hmm.
Here it doesn't matter. This, this, and this goes back on top. So you're right back to where you started from.
Mm-hmm.
Half the deck face down, half face up, and the selected card on top. At which point, you reiterate, and because of the natural break, you'll cut to the end or the beginning of the face up parcel of cards. You place this down this way, and you do this, lift them up, and it's done. Ribbon spread the cards. You say all the cards are face up with the exception of one, which I believe to be the selected card. Please name it, the Queen of Diamonds. There it is.
Good.
Yes? So after doing a trick, this is the setup for the next trick, which I refer to as the three-pile trick. Obviously, because I'm using three piles here, just keeping this out a little bit. Now you have the spectator choose any two of the piles, and the reason for doing that is that I'll turn those cards face up.
All right. This one and this one.
Oh, okay. This one and that one. This one face up. Here's what I intend to do. Shuffle the cards face to face. Like so. Okay? Continuing.